My head was clearing up, or according to Hartman, I was sinking back into the fantasy. I was convinced he was lying to me about everything. Crazy or not, the Andersons made more sense.
Tom, you got any booze on you?
Yeah, no.
We have a stash of the special stuff at the farm. Our own formula, local ingredients, medicine, clears your head right up. Makes you remember like moonbeams on the brain.
Oh, I just noticed leather patches on the elbows. That's not very rock and roll.
Tom just lost is all. Baba Yaga got to him too, the damn witch.
He's checking on it now.
Yeah, good thing he's not overreacting or anything.
Well, he's the boss.
I may need a hand here later on, Birch. The storm's bound to make you-know-who jumpy. You know how they get.
Gotcha. The doc's got me looking after Wade here, but holler if
something's wrong.
I'll do that,
Birch. I know
Birch.
Myself. It's hard to think. There's a shadow inside my head. I can only focus on writing. Everything else is a blur. I'm trapped in this cabin. Have been for days, but it's always dark outside. My editor is real. I saw her again. She's not human. It's not human. A dark presence is wearing the old woman's face. She was covered in clinging shadows. There's a hole in her chest where her heart should be. I think I've made a horrible mistake. I don't think I'm any closer to saving Alice. It's been lying to me, using me to get the story it wants, and the story will come true.
Hey, Wake. Why don't you humor Dr. Hartman and give the writing a shot, huh? The typewriter's in your room.
The white glare of the blank page in front of me hurt my eyes. My hands began to shake uncontrollably.
Hey, Wake! You stay here. I'm gonna go see what's up. You just keep doing what you're doing. Be cool, okay?
I didn't know what the chaos was all about, but it could be my only chance of getting out of here.
Where the hell did he get a damn hammer?
I don't know.
My hammer's up! Here's a friendly poke from me, old little witch!
Oh, afraid of the crazy brothers, are ya? Not so weak now! Are we? Well, things are unraveling fast, aren't they? Ha ha!
It's my storm!
Sinclair looked back. That wasn't a love tap. The crazy old fart hit her hard. If she was one of Hartman's goons, she had it coming. I could get the key to the office room from Sinclair.
Seize your destiny!
I had to get to Hartman's office. He had taken all my manuscript pages.
Come on,
that's where he'd be keeping
them. Music, Birch! It's time to pay the piper!
Maybe you could come out and beat our wrinkled, adult, diapered ass.
Let me out of here! Hartman, do you hear me? I'm gonna sue your crazy quack ass!
The markings on the tape said they were recordings Hartman had made of the sessions with his patients. I saw Alice's name on one of them. For a moment, I couldn't breathe right.
Now, Mrs. Wake, can you tell me about Alan's problems?
He's more and more out of control all the time. The parties, he's so angry all the time. He's getting violent.
Do you mean with you?
No, not with me. No, never. Sometimes I almost wish Alan would take a swing at me, because at least that lead to a conversation he couldn't just march out of. But no. Alan doesn't really sleep. And the work, well, he's not writing at all. He sits there for hours and just gets more and more frustrated. And I can't talk to him.
Yes, tell me, Mrs. Wake. What would you say to him if he'd listen?
I don't know. I want to say, I look at you, and it's not you. Just some stranger who resembles you. Looking out from behind your eyes, and I don't like that guy much. And now it's all gonna go to hell.
But you don't ever say this.
No. No. I've tried, but he's not listening. He's too deep in his own problems. Always going on about something else. I'm so afraid I'm gonna lose him. And we're not even talking anymore. He doesn't let me in anymore. He just keeps me in the dark. I'm so alone here. Even when he's home. Please help me, Doctor. Because I'm at my wit's end.
Well, if you can just get him here, I'll absolutely do my very best.
Yeah, but Doctor, you need to be careful with him. He's not just going to listen to you and cooperate. He's the most stubborn man I've ever met.
Well, I'll be sure to bear that in mind.
Hearing her voice, what she was saying made me happy and sick and guilty all at once. Worst of all, I recognized the words, the phone call from her. It had been a cut-up of this, just a recording. The photo on the wall caught my attention. In it, the clinic staff was standing outside the lodge. I knew the man next to Hartman. He was the kidnapper. Hartman had been playing me all along.
Barry?
Ow! About time!
Barry, man, am I glad to see you. We need to get to Hartman's office.
It's right next door.
You okay?
Yeah. I mean, no! The cops found me at Rose's trailer, but they didn't hassle me too much. I'm obviously a victim in this, and I demanded to be treated as such. Or else I'd sue their asses. Speaking of asses, that Fed gave me a real hard time, but I had no clue where you were. That guy's crazy, Al. But he let me go, and then I get a call from Hartman, that son of a bitch, who tells me you're here and I should come pick you up, but when I got here, two goons clobbered me and stuck me in there.
What's with the cutout?
I stole it from the diner to piss off Rose after what she did to us. That'll teach her.
Yeah, that's a harsh punishment. Come on, pal, we gotta get going.
All the pages I had on me. And more.
Alan, please. You're sliding back into the...
Tell me one more lie and I'll shoot you in the face.
Ah, well, it was worth a shot. Really, Wake, come on. Let's work together on this. You have no idea...
Hartman, shut up! Barry, get out of here. I'll catch up with you. Get a car!
Oh, Al, let's just...
Go!
Wake, listen to me. This is a mistake. Don't you see? Together we can create something absolutely wonderful with your ability and mine.
Thank you.
want access to thousands of applications? Verizon Wireless has you covered.
I don't have a light.
Take this, Al! Oh, God! Look at the house, Al! Look out!
Thank you.
calm.
Thank you.
again.
Trouble!
out of here. Can you open this gate?
Maybe.
Barry.
I slammed it shut when the nasty showed up, and the key fits kind of loose in the lock, so,
Barry.
I'm on it!
Come on.
forest, you're now leaving Bright Falls. Come back soon, sign.
We're going to the Anderson farm.
I knew you were gonna say something like that. You know what? You owe me big time for this. When this is through, if we make it, I don't care what anybody says, I'm done with darkness. You're gonna buy me a tanning bed as a gift, and I'm gonna live in it.
But
maybe that's inevitable when you deal with crazy stuff like this. It helps. This is happening, Barry. Alice, they never had Alice. She's trapped in the darkness at the bottom of the lake, but she's not dead.
Al, how can you know that?
I know, Barry. I can...
Al, I...
No, listen. I can bring her back. I can find her. There's something special about this place. The lake, it does something to the works of art created here. It makes them come true. But there's a catch. The dark presence, whatever that thing is, twists it to its own ends. That's why all of this is happening. It's using my manuscript to take over everything.
Al, I believe you.
It happened to Thomas Zane before, it happened to the Andersons.
I believe you. Crazy or not, you're not delusional. Weird shit's going down. That's a fact. I'm on board, man. I'm with you.
The Andersons knew about it, but they were too far gone to tell me with all the drugs they were on. But they wrote it down. There's a message somewhere at their farm, Barry. Just need to find it.
Look out! Al! God damn it, Al, talk to me!
I had lost my gun in the crash. Barry was nowhere to be seen.
Barry! Barry!
Oh, man, you're okay! Jeez, it's good to hear your voice! I was trying to get out of the car, but the ground gave way! Man, what a drop! Don't worry, your cutout is fine.
Forget that! Are you okay?
I hit some bushes, didn't get a scratch! There's no way you can climb down, though. It's like a sheer wall. Ah! Al! There's something moving down here!
Barry, it's a taken! Use a flare, Barry!
Woo! Yeah!
Barry, are you all right?
I'm good, Al. I'm great! Guess you never messed with anyone from New York City before, huh?
For me, okay?
Al, I'm not staying here. It's suicide. I'm going to the farm. I'm gonna go ahead and secure the area. You can catch up. Don't worry about it. I'm on the case.
Now he's Rambo. This would turn into a disaster if I didn't catch up with Barry. to destroy them to get through. Sense the movement in the woods ahead. Facing the enemy without a weapon was dangerous, but I had no choice. I could sense the movement in the woods ahead. Facing the enemy without a weapon was dangerous, but I had no choice. I could sense the movement in the woods ahead. Facing the enemy without a weapon was dangerous, but I had no choice. I could sense the movement in the woods ahead. Facing the enemy without a weapon was dangerous, but I had no choice. I could sense the movement in the woods ahead. Facing the enemy without a weapon was dangerous, but I had no choice.
Only the free
driving away from the farm, headed in the same general direction as I was. For all I knew, it was Barry, caught in the consequences of leaping before looking. Was heading for the cabin up ahead. It wasn't far. If it was Barry, I would see the damage soon. I had seen it in my dream. It was a strange spaceman or a diver in a bulky suit. He was the one who'd been placing the pages on my path. Someone had left a gun behind. Now I had a fighting chance of reaching the farm. could see the car, but there was no sight of the driver.
Hello? Anybody here?
Ah!
Barry!
Ah! Ah! No! Danny, you're not! Ah! Please! Ah! What are you? What is? Ah! No! Don't! I'm sorry! Ah!
I know you. You were in jail the other day.
I went to the farm again for the moonshine, you know? It makes you see. They're not gonna miss it. They're in the loony bin. But my buddy, Danny, I lost him. Something's gone wrong with him. It's not him. Like a real bad follow-up to a real good movie. The best friend's suddenly the bad guy. Who wrote this crap anyway?
Run through every possible course in my head. If I continue like the Dark Presence wants me to, the story I'm writing won't save Alice. It's a horror story, and it's going to kill her, and me, and everybody in this town. No one will survive. Darkness will consume everything. This is what it's wanted all along. It will be free, unstoppable. It used Alice to get to me, dangled her in front of me to keep me going. It was never going to release her. I'm going to change this. I'll escape. I've written myself into the story. I'm now the protagonist. This feels like a terrible risk, but it's the only way to save Alice. I'll be bound by the events of the story just as much as anyone else who's been woven into it. The story must stay true for this to work. There have to be victims along the way. Near escapes. Cliffhangers. In a horror story, it can't be certain that the hero will succeed or even survive. He almost has to die. I'll write my own escape into the story next. I need help. Zane's going to be the one who'll help me. I'll make it happen.
The front door was locked. The farm was still a good distance away. I'd need a car to get there fast. Barry wasn't up here, he was probably in trouble down at the farm. For a moment, I felt bad for doubting him. After all, I'd made it this far myself. But Barry was Barry.
Well, as I'm sure everyone's noticed, that storm we all felt coming is finally here. The boys at the Weather Service reckon it'll last until morning, at the very least. Pertaining to that, let me read that missing persons alert again. The Sheriff's Department's still looking for a Caucasian woman, 30 years old, slim and blonde with blue eyes. She may be lost in the woods, and it's possible she's been injured in a car accident. If you see her, please make sure you get her indoors and call the sheriff. It's bad weather to be caught out in, so if you see someone in the area who maybe looks a little confused, give them a hand, all right? This is Pat Main on KBF FM. Hoping you're all safe and warm tonight.
I'd known the brothers used to be some kind of rock stars, but it hadn't really sunk in until I saw the stage.
Al! Run! It's coming! There's too many of them! God damn!
I'm so glad you decided to go it alone, Mr. Johnson.
Shut up and
Bright Falls, rock and roll capital of America.
Hey, Al! This way to the farm! Bestseller, no reason to worry. Your cutout's good as new, right where I left it. I'll come back for it once we have the place secured.
Yeah, that's been my biggest worry all this time. We need to get this thing moved out of the way.
This is as far as I got, before they ambushed me.
Has something to say. What's that, Al?
Oh, I'm Alan Wake. I'm always right about everything. And if I don't get my way, I'll sulk all day long.
I'm always intense and moody. It makes me very attractive and mysterious. Right now, I'm just standing here because I need my best friend, Barry, to carry me. But that's okay. I can just take him for granted.
I think I see what you did there.
Yeah. It was pretty good.
Wow! You look at that thing, Al! They really went all out with this Viking crap, didn't they? Look at all this stuff! They must have done okay for themselves, so how come I never heard of these guys before?
And this from the guy who learned about Ozzy Osbourne through reality TV?
Thank you.
Sweet Springs. Man! Somewhere between memories. Hey, remember when I got you that gig? Your first real writing job. What got you started? Was this one of your episodes? In Night Springs.
Tonight's episode. The Dream of Dreams.
That's by someone else.
We join Mr. Jones as he explores the endless dreamscape, only to be brought to a sudden stop by a decidedly mundane situation. A long line of people.
Hey, Jones, right? Listen, we're gonna have to wait until his highness over there is good and ready.
Oh, wow. Who's that?
You don't know him? What are you, new? He's the guy dreaming us. Well, not just us. He dreams everything. All of this.
But wait, no. I'm the one who's dreaming. I'm asleep. Isn't this my dream?
Oh, yeah. Sure. Get real, pal. You're just another dream. I'm a dream. You're a dream. The weirdo in the diving suit is a dream. And the girl made of smiles and sunshine is definitely a dream.
But I'm pretty sure I'm dreaming this.
Well, maybe you're a really confused dream. What am I, a shrink? All I know is I'm going with the smart guys. And they say that's the guy doing the dreaming. Right there.
I don't know what that means.
It means we keep him happy. No sudden falls. We make sure he has his clothes on when he goes out in public. No chases where the monster is nipping at his heels and he runs like crazy but his legs don't seem to get him anywhere. None of that. Because if he wakes up in a cold sweat... Yeah, precisely. So we wait till he wants to move on. Keep things nice and calm.
Hey! Something's happening here.
Yeah? What's that?
What? Can't you hear that?
Oh, God help us. It's an alarm clock. Oh, it's you, isn't it? Please, man, I got a wife and kids. Please don't wake.
The Viking boat looked imposing, almost like a battering ram.
geezers had quite a production going on. Ooh, you know what, Al? If we make it through this alive, I'm gonna start representing them. Yep, sell this stuff online, maybe get a reality show going, release a new single.
Good luck with that, pal.
Hey, you find us a way out of here, okay? I'm gonna take a closer look at this stuff.
Okay?
As you regular listeners know, I tend to work through the night, but I'm not the only one. Deputies Mulligan and Thornton are taking a couple of moments off their busy schedule to join me here in the studio. Boys, how busy are you now? Deerfest is almost here, isn't it? I bet that keeps you in business.
Pretty busy, yeah.
Actually, Pat, we've been real busy with other stuff.
Which concerns an ongoing investigation. We can't talk about that, Thornton.
I wasn't gonna say anything. I was just saying we got, you know, other irons to fry.
And how would you compare your workload to last year's? Things have seemed relatively peaceful to me, but people do tend to get a little wild this time of year.
Oh, it's wild, Pat. It's pretty wild. There's been all sorts of trouble this year. Vandalism, fighting, public disturbances. A lot of people gone missing, too.
Yeah, it's pretty much the usual stuff, Pat. Just, you know, a lot more of it.
Now, is it just me, or does Deerfest get wilder every year? People seem to be more drunk, at least, or they start earlier and younger.
Oh, it's definitely not just you, Pat, but...
Definitely, Pat.
Hey, I'm talking here, Thornton. Oh, shoot, I lost my train of thought.
Not just me.
Oh, yeah, it's wilder, Pat, but actually most of the trouble seems to be coming from grown men. People who ought to know better, you know? Kids are doing fine this year.
Well, that's nice to hear at least. Boys, I want to thank you for stopping by. I'll let you get back to your patrol.
Sure thing, Pat.
Yeah, sure thing, Pat.
You've got to be kidding me.
Thank you.
me. Hang on.
Hey, let's go, man. I think we're gonna have to work together to open this gate, Al. Looks pretty heavy. Ah! Hey, I think that's the farm on the other side of the field. We're almost there. This farm is a crazy place for crazy people.
We should feel right at home then.
Come on, one more gate. Let's do this thing. Lights are out. I guess we better check the fuse box.
The power downstairs was out, but I was sure I could fix that at the fuse box.
You know, this place looks kind of lived in. I thought the Andersons were in the booby hatch. Come on, Al, let's get the lights on, huh?
Of course. We need to find where it's coming from. That's the message the Andersons talked about. That's the whole reason we're here.
Lady of the Light? Oh, that's gotta be... What's-her-face? The crazy lamp lady from the town.
Cynthia Weaver.
Right. Must be.
Okay?
We need to find Cynthia Weaver. We'll stay here for the night and head back to town as soon as it gets light.
Hey, Al. Lots of hours before dawn. Might as well get some rest. And by rest, I mean drunk.
Come on, Barry. This is...
Yeah.
What the hell?
Listen, Al. I'm sorry about this. No, seriously, because...
Find her, right? Even though you're a crazy bastard, I'm gonna stick by you, no matter what, ever, Al.
Sure, like a brother.
I'm a writer, goddammit.
Correct.
If I just wanted to, I could write 10 books a year. And they'd be the best books that year.
No, you couldn't.
That's right, I couldn't. But I could, because I'm a writer.
What? What do they put in this stuff? I feel like my brain is coming out of my nose. I'm gonna get the recipe off those coots and be a booze millionaire.
I just miss her, Barry. I just want her here with me.
I know, Al. I know. It's gonna be okay. We're gonna make it okay.
Memory unearthed by the Andersons' moonshine. I was there, an out-of-body observer. This was the night Alice and I had arrived at Bright Falls, the night Alice had disappeared. I had a chance to find out what had happened. I remembered being surprised to see the cabin dark. Alice would have never turned the lights off.
Alice! Alice!
I remembered thinking, I caught a glimpse of her form underwater, sinking into the darkness. Diving after her was the last vague memory I had of that night. After that, the next thing I could remember was waking up behind the wheel of the crash car and finding the first pages of the manuscript. I couldn't find her in all that blackness. I must have thought she drowned.
Alice!
Jagger had Alice, and so she had me.
Alice!
I'd been easy prey.
Look at the cabin. Is there someone in the window?
Alice?
Maybe she didn't drown.
Alice!
Yes.
The dark presence had touched me. She had dug her nails into my brain and used me, made me her puppet.
She must be here somewhere. Maybe upstairs in the study.
Alice!
Yes, that's where she is. You can apologize.
Alice!
You laugh at the whole thing together and put it Alice? Behind you. She's not here. You were foolish to think so. No, she's dead. She drowned.
No, no, no!
It's your fault your wife is dead. You are guilty. All she wanted was to help you write. You killed her.
Ah!
Oh, hush. There's still hope. Cauldron Lake is a special place. Here, you have the power to change things. She wanted you to write. I will tell you what to do. You can write her back. The story will come true, and all will be well again.
She had Alice, and the manuscript was the ransom for her.
Yes, I'll write. I'll fix it. I'll bring her back.
I remembered it all now. In the dark, I'd written for days, a week, almost a complete manuscript of a novel entitled Departure. Jagger had been my editor, whispering in my ear, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. I thought I was saving Alice. Even with the cobweb she put in my head, some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story, to bring a light into the cabin to release me before I could finish, to interrupt the horror story before the ending, where darkness consumed everything and everyone. Zane was weak and far away, but I had written him into the story, and his light had been enough to set me free.
It isn't here now. I'm here because it was written. I brought the light to set you free. You must hurry. We'll know I'm here. It will be back soon. It stole the skin of my armor a long time ago. She looks so old.
I had woken up, confused and groggy, my mind consumed by darkness and fear. All I could do was to escape. The week spent in the cabin had taken its toll. I was barely conscious and fading fast. Had to have cost Zane terribly, thrown him even deeper into whatever dark place he now haunted. But he had managed to weaken the dark presence, kept me safe that night.
I wrote it. It's my fault.
That's right, James Joyce. It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
Previously on Alan Wake. Under the influence of the Dark Presence, I wrote a horror story that is coming true. Jagger had been my editor, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. Some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story.
Together, we can create something absolutely wonderful.
The lake, it does something to the works of art created here. It makes them come true. My mom gave me this old light switch.
The clicker.
Alice is being kept in a dark prison. I need to find Cynthia Weaver to fix this.
It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
Expecting a record crowd from the neighboring counties. Naturally, we hope to break the record set by last year's Moose Fest in our neighboring town, Watery. Ladies and gentlemen, some people have asked me, what's the big deal about Deer Fest? And I think that this sums it up. It's about friendship and community. We've got a great party coming up, though. Let's try to hold it in until tomorrow and get through the night in one piece, all right?
Someone will come for it when the time is right. Thomas said so. He wrote it. The key is insurance. It's my job to keep it safe. Safe in the light. What was in the light?
Hello. Hello.
All the manuscript pages were gone. The FBI agent had taken them.
I think my tongue just took a crap in my mouth. Ugh. Oh, wait, we're in jail now? Al, this is not good.
That about sums it up.
Oh, I am never drinking again.
I need to talk to Weaver. She's the one in the song, the Lady of the Light.
What, the crazy lady? Ugh, whatever you say, Al, but we're stuck here. They're not gonna...
You haven't even interviewed Wake.
I had some reading to do first, Sheriff. And let me tell you, it was an interesting read. Well,
I've got you now, Raymond Chandler. It's all here. All the evidence, including conspiracy to murder a federal agent. There's no way you're walking out of here. You hear me in there, Brett Easton Ellis? Huh?
Agent Nightingale, I want to talk to your superior.
Well, we all want things, Sheriff. I wanted my... Look, that's not possible right now.
Agent Nightingale, I insist.
Wake, what's wrong?
Lady, are you stupid? It's a trick. It's an obvious trick.
Okay, I've had enough of this crap. Wake, I'm gonna trust you with this.
You're joking.
Agent Nightingale, your opinion would matter more if you were sober and if I actually believed you were here on official business.
Whoa! Get back in the cell, Stephen King. The only way you're leaving this place is over my dead...
Wait a minute.
Oh my God!
Light. We need light. It's the only way to fight this thing.
In my office. I've got your things there. Follow me.
Oh man! We're sitting ducks with the lights out!
Stay cool. I can get the emergency power on. Things. Wake, what do I need to know? What do you need from me?
They can be hurt in the light, only in the light. And I need to find Cynthia Weaver. She can help me stop this.
Light. Check. Cynthia. She lives in the old decommissioned power plant. I can get you there pretty quickly in the rescue chopper. Come on, let's get back to your friend. Wheeler, I need you to stay here.
What? No!
We're going to fetch our ride, but I have friends who need to be warned about this, and I can't be in two places at once. I need your help.
Well, okay.
Here's a list of people and phone numbers.